The sole question which arises for consideration is whether, if an order of appointment is procured by playing fraud, then whether such an appointee can be held to be a holder of a civil post in order to seek protection under Article 311 of the Constitution, and can be subject to regular departmental inquiry under the provisions of the rules governing his service conditions, or the appointment being void ab initio is liable to be cancelled without following the procedure prescribed for dispensing with the services. In the present case also, the appointment was obtained by the petitioner on the basis of a caste certificate certifying him to be a member of a scheduled tribe to which he did not belong. Thus, the very basis of the appointment of the petitioner was gone, and the appointment was void ab initio. The argument of the learned counsel for the petitioner that he had applied for the certificate disclosing his caste as Nat and had filed the certificate as was issued to him by the authorities, and thus there was no question of any fraud having been committed by him, is worthy of no credence. The assertion of the petitioner in this regard is his own without any verification from the authorities, in as much as on account of the non-availability of the records with the authorities, the veracity of the application made by him for issuing a caste certificate would not be certified. In the absence of any material, it is hard to believe that the authorities would have issued an incorrect caste certificate to the petitioner. Para, it is too much of coincidence to believe that a certificate was issued certifying him to be a member of the scheduled tribe wrongly, and the post for the said reserved category was also available, and he was appointed extending the benefit of reservation. The petitioner has now here disputed that Nat caste is not notified as scheduled caste, but what he alleges is that the authorities issued him a certificate of scheduled tribe without his involvement in any manner, and the same was filed by him along with the application form. In any view of the matter, the petitioner got an appointment on a post reserved for scheduled tribe, though he did not belong, and thus the very foundation of his appointment collapsed and cannot be said to be a legal and valid appointment in the eyes of law. In the case of Bank of India versus Avinash Dayal 2005 (7) SCC 690, where an employee got an appointment in 1976 on a post which was reserved for a member of scheduled tribe, and subsequently the caste certificate was invalidated by the scrutiny committee in 1987, which led to the termination of service. In the present case, the petitioner, though not a member of the scheduled tribe, usurped the post which should have been filled in by appointment of a member of said caste, and thus he was disqualified to hold the post, and appointment was void from its very inception. Over.